Hello and welcome to episode 14 of Let's Play Venice. This looks like it will be the final chapter of the Let's Play. With any good Civ game, and I'm talking generally here, I have a hard time not thinking about it. So after I signed off yesterday when I recorded the penultimate episode, I kept thinking about, what I can expect for the remaining 11 or so turns, and it occurred to me that I should probably send in a spy into Greece just to see if they might be building a spaceship part in your capital and see how far along they are, because they're really just one part away. And if I look at their diplomacy or their demographics, they have all the techs, so they could win at any time here. I mean, I think I said in the last episode that I feel like this will be a loss in terms of if we're gonna win or not. But there's that hope, and maybe I just don't want to get disappointed. So I want to see if I can spare a spy here. Budapest. Some of these might be really deep in, so I don't really need. Yeah. Oh, okay. So maybe I'll wait two more turns until they rig their election and I'll move them out. So I did want to point out, someone might have noticed this and wondered how that happened. So if you look at the diplomacy overview, or the World Congress, the chairman of the World Congress is the Polynesians. The reason why it's not between me and the Greeks is because when the last era dawned, we voted, well, I voted the Hawaiians as the chair of the United Nations or the World Congress, because I alone did not have the votes to win out, and I didn't want the Greeks to control it. So what ended up happening was he got the top spot, I got the second spot. So we're bouncing back and forth between each other in terms of proposing world resolutions, and this was a really good, I mean, it kind of highlights the really good diplomatic game that's in there in Civ 5, that you can kind of set things up so that you kind of edge out someone else that you don't want to be in the World Congress proposing proposals. I mean, it's not always possible to do that, but in this case I lucked out, so I'm in safe hands here. Because if you have one of these guys, the Polish who was friendly but not so much anymore, and especially the Greeks who's hostile pretty much the entire game, and that's because our play styles are completely opposed, because they want their city states, that's their trait, and I want my city states because that's how I want to win. We clash, and obviously we don't agree on how the world should be run. So if they were in here, they could be causing all sorts of trouble, forcing me to spend votes, doing stupid things. So this works out really well, because I have the cover of the Polynesians. For this, if I were to propose this by myself instead of the Polynesians, this would get probably the Egyptians and pretty much everyone else angry at us. So by doing this, I can vote for this, and hopefully this will pass without having to worry about the other civs getting mad at me. Because the way the AI works is it will look at who proposes the proposal, and whether you. If you propose something they don't like, they'll hate you for it, and if you vote against their proposals, they'll hate you for it. But there's really nothing to check for. Did you provide the votes for it to win? It doesn't check for that. Or it might, and we just don't see it. But as far as I know, the game only checks for those two things. Is your proposal to their benefit, or aligns with their grand strategy? And two, if they propose something, do you vote for or against it? If you vote for it, they'll like you a little bit more. If you vote against it, they'll not like you so much. So, I mean, there's only about 11 turns left. It's not a big deal whether I propose it or not, but I would rather not go to war with Egypt or Greece and just play this last 11 turns all the way to its conclusion. And it could, I mean, the game could end at any time, to be quite honest. What I wanted to do
Aloha
here,
mai e
I
te
forgot
wa.
that we had a declaration of friendship, so let's
A oia,
keep that
e
going.
ho'omau aku.
That they're okay with that.
A oia.
How about the Polish? Is there anything I can do with him?
Pozdrawiam cię.
Only one dice. I have only one dice. Was it trading one away? Yeah, I'm exporting one away, okay. I have a lot of gems that no one wants. And a lot of pearls. Okay. Okay. Yeah. As I was saying, this could have been a lot worse, so... I mean, I got a couple of my trade routes pillaged, but... that's the worst of it.
Soy tauta gata.
And I made another mistake here because I was so engrossed in my war that I wasn't assigning my specialists. I could have made a great artist here and pop in my golden age while this going on to get maximum gold income and not have to worry about this unhappiness. So that's me forgetting to do that.
Thank you.
going to put all my votes into here. Okay, let's see. Oh, damn. It's gonna be tight. Oh, I'm glad I took over Panama City, because that's two votes. If you're competing for Vatican City, it's not good. Oh, freedom passes. Space station passes. Okay, good. We're back to happy. Polynesia voted. Who voted? Okay.
Jak ci się podoba moja oferta?
I also realize I was a tunnel visioned here for a second, and I could have spent my faith points to buy one of these great people, so I think I should do that to speed things along. Let's buy a great scientist. Just having a look at their city. So this is what having a diplomat in their city will do, is you can have a look at their city. I think if you have a spy in your city, you have the same access. But obviously I don't have one right now. Okay, Budapest. I'm gonna go move that to Athens. Oh, let's do that as a diplomat. Just, I might get an extra vote from there, just to be safe. I mean, I wish clearing a nuclear fallout is this easy, but it is a little bit easier in Civ than in real life. Take 5 turns for my diplomat to get to the Greek capital, so I might be able to win before then because I have almost enough money now to buy another part. So in 3 turns, I can finish that and I'll buy my other booster and I should be done if I go view victory progress. So I need one booster, which I'm building. I can buy the next one and then I've already purchased this. So that's my, I guess, third option is, or my backup plan was to win by this. So I might win if the Greeks don't win in the next 3 or 4 turns. Probably 4. I need 4 turns. And buying spaceship parts with money is a freedom trait, ideology upgrade, so it's not in the base game. If you're playing this normally and without freedom and you go some other ideology or you haven't had access to it for some reason, you won't be able to buy spaceship parts. They're still at war. If I end up do end up winning this game, my roping in of the Egyptians against the Greeks might be the turning point that made me win this, because I think their nuclear exchange would have set them back quite a bit, but I can't tell for sure. I'm a bit superstitious here. I don't want to build the or attach the engine part because I almost feel like the AI will sometimes panic if they see you building a lot of parts, and they will rush their parts too. So if I don't do it, I feel like I'm not tipping my hand to the AI. And it's not out of the realm of possibility that the AI would have been programmed to look for that. If they start seeing someone building a lot of parts, they may rush their last part to win. So I want to try to save as many parts as possible and go all in on one turn. And the nuclear fallout is almost gone, so let's do that. Still making introductions. So yeah, I think I have my city-states in place. My votes are there, so it's just, will the Greeks get there before I do, either by spaceship or by diplomatic, and I need about 2 turns to do it, to win by spaceship. maybe I can buy from one of these cities. Why didn't I think of that? I could! Okay, I just bought it here. Oh, that's stupid. I could have bought it from here and not waited an extra turn. See, it's, you know, if I'm out of practice, I don't think about these things, and that extra turn or two can be the difference between winning and losing. Venice is unique. Oh, okay, I got bronze. Okay. Venice is unique in that, we can buy stuff from our puppeted cities. The puppeted cities are these little strings attached to them. It just means they're under not my direct control. And that's one way Civ has of controlling expansion. So, let's see here. View notification log. What do they get as gold? Oh, got a research boost. Free great scientist. Yeah, mission control is a nice boost. Let's build this here. Well, we'll see. We have one turn. If we lose in one turn, that's because I played really sloppily this last bit here. And it's just 7 a.m. In the morning. Okay. Let's do it. It looks like they did not complete in time, so I have the final word. Here's to Alpha Centauri. And there it goes.
You have achieved victory through mastery of science. You have conquered the mysteries of nature and led your people on a voyage to a brave new world. Your triumph will be remembered as long as the stars burn in the night sky.
Right, that was a great victory. It's such a close-run thing, even with a lot of mistakes. And I probably would not have won had they played a notch higher difficulty-wise. A little bit out of practice, like I said, when I started this series. I've played two games of Civ in the past 6 months, or 8 months, so Hopefully I'll be able to play more. But here's an interesting to add. Interesting thing to add. It is Go Beyond Earth, and this is a bit of a promo tie-in for Beyond Earth, which is the Alpha Centauri clone that they made. Unfortunately, I heard that the game wasn't as good as people hoped it would be, but yeah, they did do that. So we can have a look at our demographics. So basically, the Egyptians are way ahead of everyone. They just weren't close to building the spaceship or anything. Let's see here. Oh, and the replay is here. You can watch it. It's not loading for some reason. Okay, let's I'm going to save this, and these are all my save games, which quite a few games I've played. So if I lose a game, I just save it as a loss. So this is a win, and I want to play a few extra turns. So this is game 21, and this is A Brave New World. So this is Brave New World expansion game 21, but actually it's more than game 21 because I've played a bunch of games without the A prefix as well. So this is probably game 30 or 40. So win. We're gonna save it there. So what I want to do is I want to play to the end, at least to the UN election, just to see if I can have the votes or if I could have won that way. So if we go to diplomacy, I now have 36 votes, plus 4, so that's 44. I need 43 to win, and then I should get one more vote from each of these, and probably one more vote from here. Okay, so let's keep playing there. It feels liberating to actually finish this, because now I can actually spend money on things I want to spend on. So let's buy myself a warship. I know this doesn't really matter anymore because I've already won the game, but I'm just playing through it. these are nice. Like, these are like the RoboCop robots. And they were kind of a fun unit that they added in the original Civ game as an endgame unit that you can build with your extra uraniums. They're nuclear powered, but they're actually surprisingly not very powerful. They're mostly there for fun. Strength 150, you compare that to this, a 90, but they can have all sorts of upgrades.
Aloha, mate.
No, they don't want it. And the Mayans are kind of just a side story for most of the game because they were kind of pulling ahead at one point, but they got their territory taken over by the Huns. So they've just kind of been here for most of the game.
Look, King. I'm not the dead.
Being friendly, but not much else.
Pozdravyam cię.
Still, okay, I can view Athens now. Well, they're not well, at least they're not building their last bishop part here. They're building tanks because they're at war with the Egyptians. More nuking. Oh, it's nice that the Hawaiians also have atomic bomb now. That's good for them. Some deterrent.
Jak ci się podoba moja oferta?
Sorry. Can't give you that for free.
Det är en fin avtal. Selv en simpel tigger vill være enig.
First time I've seen the AI offer to vote for me, but I will take it. Well, they're going to vote for me anyway, so I don't know if this is even something that they would do if they weren't liberated. But it's interesting that it's actually something they would give you. But then again, I very rarely have diplomats in enemy capitals. I usually use my spies for espionage or in city-states for coups and rigging elections. So let's take that, sure. Two more turns.
I think we agree. The past is over.
This is a great use of a George W. Bush quote. So I have something of a navy back again, after I've won again. Oh, I'm getting messages here. Let's see what's going on. Okay, let's play the last turn and see how we would do if we were to run all the way to our plan A, which was a diplomatic victory.
Ireis considerar esta oferta? Muito bem.
Yeah, but they would vote for me anyways. It's just a formality at this point.
Bin fin out in. Sailing simpletig.
No, I don't want open borders. They want to settle all around me. So, sorry. You're my puppet city. You're my puppet civilization. Stay where you are. But it's very interesting, the AI at this scale, when they get revived and they have one city, it's interesting to see how they play. They almost have no military from what I can see. Here's my great artist. Let me send in one of my units to scout. Where's my tank? Oh. All the way back here. I should move it back. Okay, so I can send this artillery in. Yeah, I don't think they have any military units at this point. It's almost like they're counting on me to protect them. Same with the Portuguese. They have nothing that I can see. It could be hidden in here. But yeah. So they spent all their resources building up again. So let's do our vote. So I have ended up with 37 votes because I had 34 plus 1, 2, 3. 3 votes. So this should be more than enough. I should end up with 45 votes, I think. 37 plus No. No, that's right. 8, yeah, 45. Okay, come in, delegates. Nice, another tank. I'll keep him down here. Start a golden age, not that I care for it or need it.
Det er en fin aftale. Selv en simpel tigger ville være enig. Det er en fin aftale.
Hey mai, er på ida på kapo elka.
Oh, did the Poles settle here? They did settle a city down here. Interesting. Oh, we're back to... Oh, I'm glad the game ended before that happened. Here, world ideology, freedom... That's something I can propose, but let's see if we would have won. I would have, so 37 from Venice, for Venice, 4 from Portugal, 4 from Denmark. That's 45, and that's a win right there. So I think that's all I have for this game. Thank you very much for watching if you've stayed all the way through. This was a very fun game. I like playing Venice because it's such a different kind of game compared to a standard Civ game where you're building cities and you're building settlers. In Venice, the geography of my empire, if you can call it that, is highly dependent on the city-states have access to. So this was a city-state, that was a city-state. So that became the core of my empire, this triangle right here. And then I expanded out over time. It was a lot of fun. We had the Huns down here that we took over, and then we freed all these city-states. And you know, the theme, I mean, with Civ games, there's always themes to my games. So the theme of this game that I felt like was liberation, because I spent a lot of my time liberating city-states. So I liberated this and this. I liberated Byblos many times, back and forth. This city went back and forth at least 10 times between me and Huns. I liberated these two capital cities. So yeah, it was a very fun game, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much for watching.